The Memphis Grizzlies have been on the come up ever since they decided to go full rebuild mode in the 2018-2019 season. Since then, they've made some really smart moves that have put them in a great spot for the future. So in today's video, I tell you why the Grizzlies are only one piece away from being great. Be sure to watch till the end of the video so you don't miss me explain what type of player they need that will push them to the next level. First, let's find out how we got here. What moves did Memphis make in the past 2 years to be in such a promising position today? On February 7th, 2019, the Grizzlies traded away Marc Gasol to the Raptors, and in return, received Valanciunas along with some other players. 5 months later, the NBA draft took place, and the Ja Morant era was born. Then, a few days later, Memphis went all in on the rebuild by trading Mike Conley to the Jazz, and in return, got Grayson Allen, the draft rights to Darius Bazley, and some players that are no longer on the roster. That same day, Bazley was moved in exchange for Brandon Clark. Fast forward to November of 2020, and Memphis acquired the draft rights to Desmond Bane. So at this point, the core of the team was assembled. Jaren Jackson Jr. was drafted in 2018, Ja Morant the following year, then Bane, Allen, Valanciunas, and Clark were all acquired via trade. The only players that haven't been mentioned yet that have a pretty big impact on the team are Dylan Brooks and Kyle Anderson, but they've been with Memphis for a while. So, the Grizzlies managed to create a very solid young core, and every player mentioned is signed through the 2022 season. On top of that, more than half of them have contracts that go even until the 2023 season. But don't click off the video just yet, because now we'll discuss their performance this season and find out why they are just one piece away from being great. The Grizzlies, among many teams in the NBA, had a very unlucky season. Not one player on the team managed to play in all 72 games. Most of them missed at least 10. Morant, Valanciunas, and Brandon Clark all played about 60 games, and Grayson Allen played in 50. But then we move on to Jaren Jackson Jr. and things get worse. Due to a meniscus injury he received in the NBA bubble, he came back at the end of the season and only played 11 games. But regardless of whatever obstacles were thrown at the Grizzlies, they still competed. They ended the season with a 38-34 record, good enough to secure the 9th seed and, more importantly, a spot in the play-in tournament. Even with Jaren Jackson Jr. missing almost the entire season, they managed to rank as a top 10 defensive team. The Grizzlies excel at playing defense as a unit and forcing their opponents to turn the ball over. Offensively, they rank closer to the middle of the league, but play with a quick pace and limited turnovers, which allows them to stay competitive in tight games. Ja Morant led the way with 19 points a game and had a very similar season to his rookie year, which is fine considering that the sophomore year slump is a very real thing. Now, let's dive deeper into why the team works so well together so we can decide what the Grizzlies are missing and why adding that specific piece could turn this team into a real threat in the West. But before we get there, if you're a fan of the NBA, you should consider subscribing. It's free, it helps me out, and you can always change your mind. The Grizzlies have the mold of a championship caliber team. They just aren't exactly there yet. What I mean by this is they have a great defense when healthy and go-to scoring options, but the core is young and there's still positions that should be upgraded. At point guard, Ja brings the scoring and intensity on both ends of the floor and has the tenacity to lead his team to the next level. His backup in DeAnthony Melton proved he could be a threat from beyond the arc. Desmond Bane, a guy with tons of potential, has shown he can also be a consistent and efficient scorer in only his rookie season. Memphis also has a go-to scorer in Dylan Brooks that can put up 15 to 20 points a night. Grayson Allen does a great job at stretching the floor, keeping the tempo up with his passes, and playing above average defense. Moving over to forwards, we have Kyle Anderson, who does a little bit of everything on the floor, but is close to average in most categories. Jaren Jackson Jr. is a defensive monster who can stick with almost anyone in the NBA, and also get hot from beyond the arc. At center, the Grizzlies have a skilled big man in Valanciunas who doesn't get enough recognition for the little things he does on the floor. So, to recap things, Memphis has a point guard with the drive to be the best, shooting guards that can stretch the floor and hustle on defense, a power forward that can lock down nearly anyone in the league, and a center that can do a little bit of everything. So, what is missing here? In my opinion, it's an elite 3-and-D wing. What the Grizzlies really need is a better small forward than Kyle Anderson. It's not that Anderson is bad. In my eyes, he's a great bench player. It's just that if they want to start working towards being a real threat in the West, they need a 3 that can play great defense and bring similar value on the offensive end. Ideally, Memphis should go after a player with a similar mold to Mikal Bridges or Robert Covington. Both have crazy long wingspans, disrupt the opponent's offensive schemes, and can knock down threes with consistency. If we're looking at who the Grizzlies should target in free agency, there's not really many options. In a perfect world, Kawhi Leonard denies his option and signs with Memphis, but that seems a little too far-fetched. Instead, I could see the Grizzlies taking their time and waiting until their ideal guy is ready to be signed or traded for. So, while they might just be one piece away from being a great team, it's definitely going to take a few more seasons for them to fully develop. If you made it to the end of the video, you must have liked something about it, so why not just subscribe? With that being said, thank you so much for watching. If you like these type of videos, I post about 3 times a week, so you'll have plenty of content to keep you entertained. That's gonna be it for me, so I will hopefully see you guys in the next one.